Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and this is a problem with Hyper-V. Whenever you try to connect a virtual machine or start it, then you will get this error. And the error says virtual machine could not be started because the hypervisor is not running. In order to enable hypervisor, you need to enable virtualization technology from your computer's processor. If you have Intel computer, you need to enable Intel VTx. If you have AMD computer, then you need to enable AMD V or SVM mode from the BIOS. And I have dedicated videos on how you can enable Intel VTx or AMD V or SVM mode. You can watch those videos on the cards. In my case, it is SVM mode since I have AMD build. You will find these settings in the overclocking profile if your motherboard supports overclocking. Anyhow, you need to enable SVM mode or the Intel VTx if you have Intel processor. And after that, go to search and look for control panel. And then go to programs and features. Click on turn Windows features on or off. Now you need to find Hyper-V and enable it. You have to check this Hyper-V folder. And make sure all these subfolders are checked as well. So you need to enable Hyper-V and the subfolders. And then scroll down to find virtual machine platform and Windows hypervisor platform. You need to enable these two features as well. Find and enable virtual machine platform and Windows hypervisor platform and then click on OK. Now it will install those required features on your Windows 10 or Windows 11. And after that you have to restart your computer. But before restarting you can do one more thing. Go to search and search for CMD. And run the command prompt as admin. Now you need to type here bcd edit, then space / set, then space hypervisor launch type, then space auto. Hit enter on your keyboard. Now the operation completed successfully, and then you have to restart your PC. And after the restart, let's try to connect and start the virtual machine again. Now you can see that I am able to run the virtual machine. So this is how you can enable hypervisor on your Windows 10 or Windows 11. And that's all for this video guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. And I will see you in my next video.